Alright, so this video is pretty much just going to be me rambling about my 10 favorite games of the decade. It's not going to be the 10 best games because people can argue about that as much as they want, but this is just going to be my 10 favorite games. Now, number one to me is a no-brainer. There aren't many video games that can really change your life, but I think that my number one qualifies because Mafia 2, alright? It came out in 2010. It was my favorite game of the decade. It wasn't just because I'd never played a game like that before. I love the story, the gameplay, the characters. I love that world. I loved exploring that world, role playing, everything about it. But it was just that time period that it's set in. It's a very time specific game. It's a period piece that's set in the 40s. All the way up to the 50s. There are fictional characters, but it's a very real world, you know. Everything, all of the events in that world were real. But it's the atmosphere of playing that game and experiencing that time period, the music. I got into music. I got into rock and roll because of that game. I wasn't really into it as a kid. I got into it because of that game. I became a historian. From there, I got into my love of cinema. And even though I haven't made any movies of my own at this point, you know, that's what I grew up wanting to do. And I may never have found that without Mafia 2. So I love everything about the game. And I played it for years. It was probably the most fun I had in a game in the decade. So that has to be number one. And I played it all the way up until the second game on my list, which has got to be GTA 5. I've probably put more time in GTA 5 than any other game. This decade, I played it for years up to this point, for 6 years in a row, and I have not just hundreds of hours, I have hundreds of days played on it. And there's really nothing I can say about it that hasn't already been said. It's one of the greatest sandbox games ever made, even though they continually screw it up with new updates. They find a way to keep it alive and to keep people coming back, and it seems that I always do, even if it's for a short time and I leave again. But that's probably got to be my number two game because of how much time I put into it. Number three, I think, has got to be another game that came out in 2013, BioShock Infinite. And even though this list includes multiplayer as well as single player, I am a big single player fan. I was very excited for. I actually didn't know about this game coming out till right when it was released, and I got on board. I got it, you know, the sequel, the much awaited sequel to BioShock, which is one of the greatest and most influential games. BioShock Infinite's right up there with it, you know. The open-ended storytelling, you know, much was made about this game. It was a potential Game of the Year candidate. It just unfortunately came out with some other great games that year. Probably the best year for gaming of the decade. It was an innovative title as well. It probably could have been better than it was, but I still think it's one of the best games ever. You know, Troy Baker gives a great performance. That's my favorite role of his. It introduced me to him. And the gameplay is incredible, you know. That world design, everyone has an argument, but a lot of people have compared it favorably to the first BioShock, some saying it's just as good, if not better. I'm not sure where I stand on that debate. I could go either way. So, that's number three on my list. Number four, I more or less have to put Minecraft here because, just like GTA, you know, they were the two best-selling games ever. I experienced both of them at around the same time, and in truth, they're both, you know, two of the greatest sandbox games ever made. Likewise, I spent a lot of time on Minecraft. I remember when I was still in high school, we used to come in the morning and we'd have a little bit of time on the computers before class started. And our teacher let us go on the internet and play computer games and all that. And a lot of kids were playing Minecraft. It had just come out at the time. And I wasn't the least bit interested in it. I gave it no time of the day. But then, a few years later, well, not even that long, it was in 2013, it came out for PlayStation 3 at the time. And I decided to pick it up and try it. And I ended up really liking it. It's an important time in my life, and I kind of needed something to take the edge off. And I really enjoyed Minecraft. I played it for years. I put a lot of time into it. I've since grown out of it because you shouldn't be a grown man playing Minecraft, but every once in a while I come back to it and find things to enjoy about it. Number five is probably got to be Battlefield 3. In a time where Call of Duty was going down and there needed to be a competitor, Battlefield stepped up. I always liked Bad Company and the Bad Company series, but Battlefield 3, in the eyes of many people, was the biggest and best one yet, and part of me agrees with it. I had a lot of fun on there. I got a taste of something new, and unfortunately, no. Recently, Battlefield hasn't been doing so well, but I do think that if the games were to take off in the footsteps of Battlefield 3, they'd be in a very good place. Alright, number 6. If this was just a single player list, this game would be a lot higher, but I gotta put Uncharted 4, even though that's one of the most recent games on this list. I gotta put Uncharted 4. Huge fan of the series. Great ending to the series, and I remember staying up late for the midnight release of it. One of the highly anticipated games for me in a long time, and I think it's one of the most beautiful games ever made. So it's got to be on the list. Great video game. Maybe my favorite PS4 game. Alright, and now we're getting into territory where there's a lot of games that could be interchangeable. So I'm just going to throw probably Bloodborne in there at number 7. One of the most stylistic, I want to say, I love the aesthetic of it. One of the best aesthetics in modern times. I'm going to put that at number 7. I'll probably put, there's going to be a lot of PS4 games on here, because I didn't play a whole lot of PS3 games, you know, after 2011. I didn't buy a whole lot of games, so I'm probably going to put Metal Gear Solid 5. That's probably going to be number 8, even though I played it like a year or two after it came out. Kojima's a master. It isn't his best Metal Gear game, but I really liked it. Really liked the story, really liked the gameplay, the stealth. I got to put that on the list. Death Stranding will most definitely be on the list, so I'll probably have to change that when Death Stranding comes out. So I gotta leave at least one spot for Death Stranding if I don't want to take something off. And I'm not really sure, you know, what to put at the very end of the list. Maybe Battlefield 1, because I put so much time into it. I don't really know. But this video is getting kind of long. That's 10 minutes. That's probably my 9 or 10 favorite games. We're probably going to change the list when Death Stranding comes out. If Ghost of Tsushima was out this year, it would definitely make the list too, but it isn't. But it's been a good decade of games. Not as good as the last one, but there's still been some essential titles that have come out, and I have put a lot of time into playing games, so I thought it was important to do a little bit of a retrospective. Mafia 2, man. I really miss Mafia 2, man. That's definitely number 1 on the list, and, you know, all the other games are pretty good, too. So it's just my favorite games. Maybe not the most objective list, but it's just my list of the games that have made the most impressions on me.